哎，我有话要说。
我的呢？
不不不，你们听我说。
哪有我的讲嘛？对了。
您有意见要发表吗？让我们一起进行大家谈。
听众朋友们，大家好，欢迎收听德州中文台。我们在今天啊，特别为朋友们带来的一个特别的节目。在今天我们的大家谈呢，特别为朋友们邀请的安排的呢，这是来自这是救灾中心 FEMA 啊的这工作人员Miss Rebecca Kelly 参加我们的节目。那么对于在 Hurricane Beryl 之后，我们休斯顿地区不论是哪个族裔啊，都受到了大的影响，在各位的家庭方面、住屋方面、生活方面，不论是在经济方面，或者是说在安全方面，都有冲击。而 FEMA 呢，是我们在每次碰到了大的自然灾害冲击的时候，在国家方面、政府方面，所提供的一个我们的求助单位。那么今天我们就和Miss Kelly 在接下来的讨论当中呢，我们会来谈一下、了解一下。在这一次 Hurricane Beryl 在我们 Houston 侵袭之后 FEMA 所提供的这一方面的援助，因为呢坊间当然有各种不同的说法，但是我们相信呢，来自这是完全的官方说明啊，这是绝对正确的。所以欢迎我们的朋友们一块收听。接下来我们先欢迎这是 Miss Kelly， 请她和大家打个招呼。 Let's welcome Miss Rebecca KellyHello, Ms. Kelly, welcome to join the show today.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me today. We have some really important information that I would like to provide about FEMA, how a disaster gets declared, and how FEMA works to support communities recover from the recent storm.
好，在这里呢Miss Kelly 呢也讲了，她也很希望能够借由我们今天的机会，在这个节目当中告诉我们的听众朋友，到底 FEMA 它是在做些什么，然后它怎么样来确认这个灾害。所以这个我们这一次 Hurricane 只是 Category 1 Level 1是最轻的，那么如果是 Category 5呢，是不是还没有发生以前他们就要 clarify 这个，就已经认定它这是 disaster 呢？他们就必须要赶快进来呢？到底他们是怎么样子做的？而 FEMA 到底做些什么工作？有人说讲了个半天 FEMA 什么都不做，只是说而已，是吗？我们下边请Miss Kelly 和大家来谈一下。 Yes, Miss Kelly, since you mentioned about FEMA, how does FEMA work? I think we are all familiar with FEMA, this name, but how does FEMA work? The detail or important part, could you highlight that for us first?
Yes, I can. I'll be happy to. Together withseveral hundred people, we conduct a thorough disaster assessment of the impacted areas to determine the extent of the disaster, the impact on individuals, communities, and public facilities, and then we determine at that time the types of federal assistance that may be needed. This information is provided by the governor to the president.And we determine at that time the severity and magnitude of the affected response that may be beyond the capacity of the state. And that is when FEMA steps in to provide the assets, resources, and support to get everyone in that community on the road to recovery.
好，朋友们，在刚才 Miss Kelly 就说呢，这个 FEMA 呢，其实他们是一开始有几百个人啊，先开始对于受灾地区要有一个全面的检测，来了解它的灾情、它的深度、它的广度，然后呢，来决定它是哪一个我们说层面吧，是 就像飓风一样，有一级、二级、三级、四级、五级，到底是在受灾方面的是哪一级？然后他们在这里呢，来看在FEMA 可以提供哪些帮助。不过在这之前，这一个对于在受灾地区，不论是个人啊，就是私人的，或者是公共的设施、公共机构，还有这些像是电啦、水啦，到底有哪一些影响，他们都必须要事先有一个检测，有一个评估，然后再由州长送交到更高一层的，到总统这边，然后再看一下在 FEMA 方面，在这个损失方面，在这个受灾方面， FEMA 再接着往下进来提供，在居民方面以及州政府方面，尤其是在当这个损失过大，在州府方面无法负担，无法提供足够的协助来帮助自己的州民时，那么 FEMA 是绝对绝对要进来帮助大家的。所以 FEMA 这个名字我们听得很熟悉了，它真正的工作是怎么做的呢？在刚才 Miss Kelly 为大家做了一个说明，联邦紧急事务管理署，这个属于联邦机构，是这样子来运作的。好，那么下边的话，我想我们就要有一些问题我们可以和 Miss Kelly 讨论的啊。那么就是像我们这一次 Hurricane Beryl 到我们 Houston 来了，那么 FEMA 有哪一些 provide 哪一些帮助，另外呢还有谁有资格可以提出申请，我需要给他些什么样的资料，有没有 deadline。 所以这一些我们下边先请 Miss Kelly 和大家来了解一下。Okay, Ms. Kelly, next question for you is under Hurricane Beryl. Now, what kind of assistance we can receive from FEMA in response to the hurricane in Houston? And who is eligible to apply for it? And any deadline? And what kind of documentation or work proof you will need us to provide?
Thank you for those questions. Right now, the governor's office has requested that 42 counties in Texas be designated for disaster assistance funding. We have help for individuals, families, homeowners, and renters at this time. If you have insurance, you should file a claim with your insurance company immediately.FEMA assistance cannot duplicate those benefits covered by your insurance.
Oh.
We cannot duplicate those benefits.
Okay.
However, we can help you get on the road to recovery. The fastest way to apply is to go to our website, disasterassistance.gov, and you can apply online.You type in your zip code and you start filling out the application. Or you can call the FEMA helpline at 1-800-621-3362. And there are specialists standing by to assist you with completing your application. If you use a video relay service, captioning services will be provided, and we have a significant number of translations. I believe we're translating into 17 different languages at this time.
Okay.
Some of the questions that you will be asked are, as a result of this disaster, do you need assistance in any of the following categories? Employment, finance, food, housing, legal, or medical?The second question will be, what describes your housing situation?
Yes.
Do you rent? Do you own? Do you live on a rural property?
Mm-hmm.
The third question will be, has your home flooded as a result of this disaster? Yes or no? The fourth question is, have you or members of your household experienced life-changing events as a result of this disaster? And there are significant number of questions like the ones that I just provided that will be asked of you.
Okay.
Once you have applied for assistance, what's next? Your request is reviewed to determine if an inspection is needed.
Mm-hmm.
You will need to provide the owner or renter's proof of residency and let the specialist know how many individuals are living in your home and the impact of what this disaster has created for your home and personal property.
那么 FEMA 对于在里边包括了不论是家庭、个人或者是 business owner 都可以向 FEMA 来申请就是联邦救灾补助，但是呢也要记得啊，朋友们，你有 home insurance， 你有你自己另外的 insurance cover 啊，会协助你在风灾之后的修复工作的话，那么 FEMA 本身它这边特别强调，它不是 double insurance， 你不可以 double 用，你有又申请到 FEMA 来修房子，然后再跟自己的 home insurance 再来 claim 这个修补房子，他们不可以 duplicate， 绝对不可以 double insurance， 这个是不行的，所以要提醒我们的朋友们要在这里要多为注意。然后你可以提供些你的包括了你的照片记录，这一些都可以当做你在申请 FEMA 的补助，在这个灾害补助方面的资料。那么 FEMA 呢，它也有它的这个 website 啊，就是 disaster.com， 你可以在上面就是填入你的资料，你的这个受灾的情形，来提供 FEMA 来作为参考审核是否要可以提供你在这一方面的协助啊，在联邦方面的协助。那么朋友们也可以到德州中文台的网页上，你直接到我们的主网页你好 Houston.com 上面，你就可以看到我们已经有中文的翻译啊，在这个上面，在这里呢，朋友们可以有一些基本的在填写这个资料上面，你可以做一个参考。那么这一次的风灾啊，造成休斯顿绝大部分很多的民众都受到了影响，那么很多的朋友也都在等待 FEMA 方面的帮助。那么在 FEMA 方面呢，是尽量的帮助大家，但是有一些要求，有一些基本要求，希望朋友们要特别的注意。好，那么在接下来我想我们要和Miss Kelly 呢来看一下，现在来讲的话，有的时候我们说这个房子啊，你不能够住了，或者去住 hotel， 好，这个费用 FEMA 可不可以补助？那么要怎么样子来申请？有没有一些特别的要求？我想接下来我们就请 Miss Kelly 就这个问题和大家来谈一下。 OK， Miss Kelly， we would like to know， since under Hurricane Beryl a lot houses power outage, even now, still power outage, still no power. They have to stay in some hotels. Then those costs, will FEMA not reimburse? Will FEMA provide any help on those situations?
Once a survivor or an owner or a renter has applied, a FEMA staff member will contact you to discuss your disaster caused damage. They may request more information to support your eligibility for assistance or temporary rental assistance.
Okay.
A FEMA specialist will contact you about the temporary rental in the approved hotel. This is direct pay to the hotel. Once you have opened a case file, then that information will be provided to you, which hotels are supporting the temporary sheltering assistance program and where you should go to find a hotel room. They will recertify a candidate every 30 days for their hotel stay.
Okay.
It's very important to stay in touch with your case manager.
Mm-hmm.
They will let you know how much money you've been approved for and what assistance programs you are eligible for.
好，在这里呢 ，Miss Kelly 的这个回答就是是的，在 FEMA 方面是可以提供，就是在如果必须要住到 hotel 去的话 ，FEMA 是会提供相关的费用经费方面。而对于怎么样子去住，要有住多久，或者是说你符合哪一些在 FEMA 或者是联邦政府的救助的计划，不同单位提供的不同的救助计划，这些都可以得到。但是第一件事情就是，朋友们，你要先去申请，先要到 FEMA 的网页或者呢电话，或者到他们的 Help Center 去申请，去填表，把你的情形你要先上报，先要告诉他们，然后他们会审核，你会有一个 case manager， 就是对于你的这个案子，你的申请的一个处理的负责人，那么他们会来看你的案子，来决定你可以得到多少的在 FEMA 方面的协助，应该来讲金钱方面的协助。然后去住 hotel 的话，这个花费是由 FEMA 直接付给 hotel， 那么这个 hotel 将是由 FEMA 指定的啊 hotel， 并不是我们自己随便选的，这些 hotel 是跟 FEMA 有合作的，所以 FEMA 会指定你到哪一个 hotel， 那么在里边费用你就不用担心，由 FEMA 直接和 hotel 去这个交涉。每30天将会重新审核一次你申请住 hotel 的这一个情形，所以呢这基本上应该就是如此，朋友们记得先要申请。好，那么接下来我们想，我们在最近都看到了有一个750块钱 $750 的这个 help from FEMA， 我们看一下这是怎么来的，说是48小时之内啊你就可以拿到了，就要不要还呢？这个是怎么来的呢？要怎么申请能够那么快就拿到呢？我们看请 Miss Kelly 来谈一下。Miss Kelly， we now heard about $750 help from FEMA. the shortest time if we apply and we can get in 48 hours. Okay.
Yes,
can you let us know more about this $750, how to apply for it?
Sure.First thing, when you apply for disaster assistance, we will need proof of your identity, proof of your occupancy, proof of your ownership or rental agreement, proof of the number of individuals living with you in your home, proof that the damaged property was your primary residence, and we will need any photos,or documents that you have received from your insurance carrier denying you coverage. Yeah, and then we'll need a bank account because we direct deposit the funds in your account. Okay. Many people don't even have insurance. So if you got a denial letter, if you are underinsured or uninsured, we will need those letters as well.
Okay.
If you have no insurance, then you tell the case manager, I don't have any. Or here's a letter I received from my insurance company denying coverage of a new roof. So you take all of those documents and you will either upload them if you have a scanner or a fax machine to your application online, or you can go to a disaster recovery center and they will upload those documents for you.
Okay.
And then that starts the process of what serious needs assistance, which is the $750. It's called serious needs assistance. If you need that right away, I lost my medicine. I lost all the food in my refrigerator.
Yes.
I lost, we left with nothing. Then that will generate the first payment, which is a grant. It does not need to be repaid, and none of the FEMA funds need to be repaid.
Do we need to file for the income tax, the tax return?
Impact any of the other services or anything else you may be receiving from the government currently. It does not impact that whatsoever.
Okay. And one extra question for this 750 help from FEMA. We have home insurance, and the insurance will probably cover basic $500 for any kind of the loss or damage at this property.
Right.
If we already received $500 from the insurance, can we still apply for $750 from FEMA?
Yes. We do not duplicate their benefits. However, you may have losses that are not covered by your insurance carrier.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where we come and fill in those gaps.
Okay. 好，朋友们，重要的讯息在这最后要带给大家。我们现在都听到了有个750块钱的 FEMA 的帮助啊，这一个help 呢，$750呢，说你48小时之内就可以得到。要提醒大家啊，这个要得到是可以的啊，但是呢，你必须要提供 FEMA 包括了你在生活上面的损失。你的药物的损失，或许你可以马上就得到 FEMA 在这一方面的协助。然后呢，你的冰箱里面的东西烂了，你现在呢生活方面啊受到了巨大的影响。那么最最重要的是，你要有你的保险公司的拒绝赔偿，拒绝不能说赔偿，就是拒绝维修。那么这些帮助，这些来自 FEMA， 也就是来自 Federal Government 的帮助呢，我们就会想说，哎呀，那我这个今年的报税的话， IRS Uncle Sam 那边我是不是得要记上一笔呢，报上一条呢？不用啊，在 FEMA 的这一些来自联邦政府的帮助跟各位的个人的税务啊，或者这些税务方面没有任何的关系。而且呢，在来自联邦政府的这个帮助，来自 FEMA 的帮助，你也不需要当说，哎，我以后我这个750块钱要还。但是呢，强调的是，他们不是 duplicate 啊，不是双重的保险的这个概念，所以要提醒朋友们特别的注意。好，下边的话我们来讨论一下啊，这个就是如果说现在我们后院的篱笆倒了，但是呢我们的房子保险是一个 high deductible， 7000块、8000块、9000块，你这个篱笆修它大概只要3000块，保险公司告诉你对不起，这是你的 deductible 基本自付额，它不付。这种情形下，在 FEMA 方面是否会可以帮助，可不可以申请这750块钱的这个补助？我们来问问看。Okay, Miss Kelly, next question: If the homeowners have a high deductible, let's okay $9,000, and for the fixing the damaged fences, it will only cost $3,000, so it's not over $9,000. Insurance will say, "Oh, that's under your deductible, so it's not our responsibility. You need to pay for it." Under this condition, can homeowners still apply for this $750 help from FEMA?
Seniors clear their yard, cut trees, get fences back up. We have so many programs that we can offer. So if we can't help you, we're not just going to walk away.
Yeah.
We're going to give you some lifelines and some nonprofit agencies and other federal agencies that can assist you further.
Okay.
We are not going to walk away and say, oh, sorry. We're very sorry about, you know, that tree in the middle of your roof. I understand insurance is a profit center. FEMA is provided to the taxpayers free of charge, does not have to be repaid,
mm-hmm.
and you are entitled to this as a United States citizen or of someone who occupies your home who is a citizen.
Okay. 刚才在他回答的时候呢，有一部分可能这个讯号不好，所以朋友们没听到啊。那么他的回答是，就是是的 ，FEMA 还是一样会帮助这一些。如果你的 deductible 这个基本自付额在房屋保险方面非常的高，而现在你的修复费用还没有到达你的基本自付额，你必须要自付的时候呢 ，FEMA 是可以让你申请这750块钱的补助，所以这个是没有问题。另外呢，对于就是 FEMA 本身，它有许多一块合作的不同的 agencies 啊，这一些单位 包括你要修树，到大树倒下来压垮了你的屋顶，你要倒要怎么样子，要找人修树，这一些移除这一些段落的大的树枝，或者你的这个前庭后院，或者你的房子、你的墙壁，那有一些这一些可能保险公司不会没有办法提供，或者是说在费用方面他不会提供，所以呢，这些你都可以和FEMA联系。FEMA自己也许他并不是提供这一些方面的帮助，但是他有许多一块合作的单位，这一些 agencies 他们就会提供，他们会把你的问题、你的需求转给这些不同的 agencies， 然后由他们来提供你需要的帮助。 FEMA 绝对不会，刚才 Miss Kelly 讲绝对不会说哦，这不是我的事，对不起，不在我的工作范围内， Sorry, I feel sorry， 但是呢你自个儿想办法，他们就掉头走人，这绝对不是 FEMA 的做法。而且他强调 FEMA 所来的经费就是我们纳税人的钱，所以我们有100%、200%、300%、400%、500%的这样子的这个使用 FEMA 经费的权利，我们有绝对的权利可以使用，所以记得要去申请。 And thank you. And also, since power outage right now, I know we have speakers who live in Kingwood, Woodland, still no power. Okay, some people have their power back last week, some just one day, no power.
Yeah.
Those people were super lucky. But even just one day or 10 hours without power or 12 hours lost the power, compared to 3 days, 1 week, can they still apply for the help?
Yes, of course. If you're a taxpayer, you are entitled to every service that the federal government can provide on your behalf.
Okay.
I cannot be more clear on that. You are a citizen of the United States, and we do not let anybody who needs help go without help. We're going to get you in touch with someone who can help you if we can't.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
That's very important. That's very important. Thank you.
Thank you. And please call me with any further questions or...how we can assist you further with providing information to the community and individuals who need to learn about it.
I will. 好，刚才呢这个问题就是大家不少的朋友都断电，都是停电了，但是停电一天，停电8个钟头、12个钟头，跟停电了7天相比，那么听众的问题就是，在这种的比较情形下，人家停电7天去申请 FEMA 的750块钱的补助，这是理所当然的。我只停电8个小时或者10个小时，我可以申请吗？是不是 FEMA 做这样子的比较以后，一看就是，哎呀，你不行，赶快把我给踢开了。那么这个问题，刚才 Miss Kelly 的回答就是，你绝对有100%、200%、300%、400%、500%的权利来申请 FEMA 的750块钱的补助。是的，你也可以申请。FEMA 绝对不会因为你只停电8个小时，别人停电7天，而把你的申请就是剔除，认为你不合格，不会的。也请你一样的对 FEMA 他们的服务、他们的救助、他们的安排，请你要直接跟他们联系，因为他们所提供的750元的这个补助里边，就是你已经缴交的税款，你已经放在里边的，事先放在这里边的这个金钱，所以我们都有100%的权利，我们可以申请他们的补助。好，我们的时间呢，今天这个简短的访问呢，在这里差不多要告一段落了。我们在这里呢，先要谢谢我们听众朋友的收听，也希望朋友们在 Hurricane Beryl 在袭击我们休斯顿已经 一个半礼拜之后呢，大家都能够在生活方面恢复到正常，能够把各位的损失降到最低。而 FEMA 这个在联邦这个保险方面提供大家的帮助，我们也希望呢在今天的访问能够对需要的朋友们，能够在联邦紧急事务管理署方面的协助，能够为您在生活的不便当中增加一点帮助啊。那么再次提醒大家，在他们的800号的电话，您可以直接的联系18006213362，或者到 disaster.com 上面语言方面的协助。 Well, thank you so much, Miss Kelly, and really appreciate all the important and very helpful information you provided to our audience. Thank you so much.
Thank you so very much for having me today. I appreciate it, having the opportunity to speak with your audience and the community.
Thank you. Okay.